covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News, first at 4.
We begin with Commitment 2010 and a new governor for the state of Florida.
Nothing in my life has honored me as much as your willingness and the willingness of everyone in Florida, the Florida voters, to put their faith in my plan for turning around the great state of Florida. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Well, as he has said throughout his campaign, let's get to work. Republican Rick Scott emerges as the winner in a very tight race for governor of Florida. Hello, everyone. I'm Tiffany Kenny. Thank you for joining us. Felicia Rodriguez is off this afternoon. Right now, Scott leads with more than 72,000 votes over Sink. But again, Scott declared victory today after Sink conceded the race. Stefan Holt kicks off our team coverage from the Scott camp in Fort Lauderdale. Stefan?
Good afternoon, Tiffany. I'm standing outside the Marina Hilton in Fort Lauderdale. This was campaign headquarters for the Scott campaign. While the results were coming in, and it ended up being the campaign headquarters into the morning time, 15 hours after the polls closed, there was still no clear winner, and folks here, as well as across the state of Florida, still had no idea who had won this governor's race. A day that started with uncertainty and is now ending with a governor-elect.
Florida is open for business.
With those words, Governor-elect Rick Scott put a victorious end to one of the costliest gubernatorial races in Florida history, and now is set to take on Tallahassee.
Today I have a message for the thousands of Floridians who are hurting. Don't give up.
That's right.
I'm giving you my word. Better days are coming.
But the race was anything but certain. Exit polls showing it was too close to call, with Scott edging over opponent Alex Sink with just 1%. At 2:15 a.m., a confident Rick Scott didn't declare victory, but encouraged his supporters he would pull it off.
I was hoping that we were not going to have a repeat of 2000 with Palm Beach County, because they were the last to get their ballots counted. And that I don't think they came in until just after 4 a.m. I think we still felt that Rick would have won.
Alex Sink conceded the race just after 10:30 a.m. to the cheer of Rick Scott's supporters. But Scott had a message to those who voted for his opponent.
I know I have some work to do to earn your support, and I'm going to do my best. I promise you that I will work with Floridians who want the best for Florida without regard to politics. Starting today, I work for every Floridian. Yes.
And Governor-elect Scott has smashed all campaign spending records on a gubernatorial race, spending $60 million, much of that his own fortune that he earned as a CEO. But just like the governor's tagline, let's get to work, that's exactly what he's doing starting today. He says his next stop is Tallahassee, where he will start setting up a transition team. That's the latest from here, reporting live in Fort Lauderdale this afternoon. Stefan Holt, WPBF 25 News.